Hello and welcome to this channel. And if you are the first time here, subscribe to the channel by clicking the subscribe button to see the latest technology videos. In this video, we are discussing about Java Server Pages JSP. So API for the generated servlet. So the container generates a class from the JSP that implements the HTTP JSP page interface. And inside the JSP, the methods can be overridden, like JSP init, JSP destroy, and JSP service. So if you are using the Tomcat web server, the generated servlet extends org.apache.jasper.runtime.http.jsp page. So initialization of a JSP page. So declare methods for performing the following tasks using JSP declaration mechanism. Read persistent configuration data, initialize resources, and perform any other one-time activities by overriding JSP init method of JSP page interface. And you can customize the initialization process to allow the JSP page to read persistent configuration data, initialize resources, and perform any other one-time activities by overriding the JSP init method of the JSP page interface. So finalization of a JSP page. So declare methods for performing the task using JSP declaration mechanism. Read persistent configuration data, release resources, and perform any other one-time cleanup activities by overriding JSP destroy method of JSP page interface. And you can release resources using JSP destroy method, and the methods are defined using JSP declaration. Then, general rules of syntax. JSP tags are case sensitive and tags can be based on XML syntax. Attribute values are always quoted similar to XML, either single or double quotes can be used. And JSP pages are typically named with a .jsp extension. White space is preserved within the body text of a JSP document when the document is translated into a servlet. JSP syntactic elements, type of element, template content, element content. Everything in your JSP page source file that is not a JSP element includes all static content. Directives, instructions you place in your JSP page to tell the JSP implementation how to go about building your page, such as to include another file. Scripting elements used to embed Java code into your JSP pages. Actions. Actions provide high-level functionality in the form of custom XML style tags to a JSP page without exposing the scripting language. And standard actions include those to create, modify, and otherwise use Java beans within your JSP page. JSP element syntax. Output comment, visible comment, return comment, declaration, Java declaration, JSP declaration, Java language declaration. Expression is Java expression. Scriptlet Java statement. JSP scriptlet Java statement. Directives JSP directive type. Actions JSP action. Template conduct. So in most cases, a large percentage of JSP document consists of static text known as template. So everything that is not part of a JSP element is template content. And there are three ways to place comments in a JSP page. Write an HTML comment, write a JSP comment, and embed a comment within a scripting element. And in almost all respects, the HTML in JSP looks like a normal HTML. And it follows the same syntax rules and is simply passed through to the client by the servlet creator to handle the page. Template content, output comments. This is a way to write a standard HTML comment. Hidden comment. The second way to write a comment is to use JSP notation. Scripting language comment. The only type of nested comment allowed by JSP specification is a scripting language comment. So JSP elements or directives. So directives provide additional information to the JSP container and describe attributes for your page. The general syntax is @directive, JSP directive, dot directive. So the three directives in JSP 2.0 are: first directive, page purpose, controls properties of the JSP page. Includes the contents of a file into the JSP page at a translation time. Tag library makes a custom tag library available within the including page. So the directives configure how the container when creating servlet generate the Java code. And directives are typically used to set the global values within a particular JSP page, and therefore they affect the entire page. And since the directives pass information to the JSP page, they doesn't produce any output to the current output stream of the JSP page. So page directive give high level information to the servlet that results from the JSP page. Control which classes are imported. Page import java.util. What MIME type is generated. Page content MIME type. How multi-threading is handled. Page is thread safe equal to true default. Page is thread safe equal to false. What page handles unexpected errors. Page error, page.jsp. So other page attributes control page referring, exception handling, and the scripting language and so forth. So this was a brief discussion on Java server pages, and we'll be discussing more on Java in the upcoming videos. And if you are the first time here, subscribe to the channel by clicking the subscribe button to see the latest technology videos. Thank you for watching this video. Bye for now.